Russell Wilson to the Washington football team. There, I said it. Now, is it true? Well, maybe not, but it's possible. In an interview with Dan Patrick the other day, Russell Wilson was very vague on his future with Seattle Seahawks. And there's been a lot of reports today about Seattle not being very happy with the trade talks with Russell Wilson. There's also been a lot of other reports that links Russell Wilson to the Las Vegas Raiders. But here's why I think that Washington would be a very good landing spot for Russell Wilson if he in fact does get traded. First of all, Washington has a strong defense. Now, they don't have all the pieces in place just yet, but that strong defense has really kept them in a lot of games this past year. Quite frankly, that defense is what has gotten Washington this far. And Wilson would have weapons to throw to. He's got Terry McLaurin, who could really be a scorcher for you down the field, as well as a very reliable emerging tight end in Logan Thomas. And then you look at the backfield, a really good solid running game with Antonio Gibson, who can also be a good pass receiver out of the backfield, as well as J.D. McKissic, who has been a very big surprise for us. And even the offensive line hasn't been too shabby. The offensive line, for me, was very surprising this year. I thought they played pretty well. They could always be improved, and I think if you, in fact, do go out and you get a Russell Wilson, then you may have to look into the draft as far as drafting some offensive talent or offensive line talent. I really feel like we still need a good, strong left tackle. Now, Russell Wilson has led the Seattle Seahawks to 8 playoff appearances in his 9 seasons with Seattle. And he has also taken them to 2 Super Bowls with 1 Super Bowl blowout win against the Denver Broncos. Just take a look at Russell Wilson's stats, and his stats pretty much speak for themselves. Career stats for Russell Wilson. 33,946 yards passing, 267 touchdowns, 81 INTs, 4,506 yards rushing, and a QBR of 101.7. Those are some great stats, and quite frankly, that's the reason why that he's going to be a future Hall of Famer. Should Russell Wilson become available, and it's very likely now that he actually may, what is it going to cost to bring him to Washington? Well, if you look at what Washington had offered Matthew Stafford, who, then again, he's a franchise quarterback, but he has not led a team to the Super Bowl, yet let alone a Super Bowl win. However, what they were offering for a trade in Matthew Stafford was a first-round draft pick and a third-round draft pick. Obviously, it's going to take a lot more to bring Russell Wilson to Washington. I think you would be looking at least 2 first-round draft picks, maybe a couple of third-round draft picks. Pretty much the same compensation that I think that a trade with Deshaun Watson would probably command as well. So would Washington bet the farm on bringing Russell Wilson in? Well, honestly, it's really not much of a betting. Russell Wilson is already a proven winner. He unquestionably would make the Washington football team an instant Super Bowl contender. The team does have some other holes to fill, but I really don't feel like they have very many holes to fill. And I believe being able to go ahead and pull the trigger to bring somebody like Russell Wilson into the fold, you have to do it. I think right now, if you look at the situation for Washington, they have a lot of options. They have already just have signed Taylor Heinicke to a 2-year deal. So we know that Taylor Heinicke is going to be back and he's going to be competing probably for that starting position. So if Washington's not able to bring in any free agent quarterback or to bring in a quarterback in via trade, then I think you definitely look at Taylor Heinicke, and then you also look at keeping Alex Smith. Yes, I'm going to try my best to keep Alex Smith. I just don't have the heart to get rid of him. But just suppose that you do wind up getting somebody like Russell Wilson. Well, obviously, he's going to be the unprecedented starter of the football team. So you're going to have a solid guy in Taylor Heinicke, probably more than likely backing up Russell Wilson. Let's not forget about Kyle Allen. So in my opinion, you have the quarterback position covered. You've got a solid backup who has already had playoff experience and is young. And of course, you've got the veteran who has Super Bowl experience, who can still use his legs to extend plays, and has been one of the most accurate quarterbacks. You've seen Russell Wilson kind of scramble around, and then you look like he's just heaving it up in the air, but yet every single time it seems like somebody's going to come down with it. Now I'm talking about his wide receivers. So to me, if he's able to make pass completions like that, he's a pretty accurate quarterback. He's also a very deep threat type of quarterback. He's got a good arm on him. He can run for the first down. I mean, he would be perfect for Ron Rivera, Russell Wilson. So if you compare the Raiders to the football team, you're comparing the coaches. Certainly, John Gruden is an excellent coach. I think he is doing a pretty decent job of turning the Raiders around. But you look at Ron Rivera, and Ron Rivera took a 3-13 team in 2019 and turned them into a 7-9 team in 2020 when the division got into the playoffs. That's a pretty good feat, I think, if you ask me. And Ron Rivera, certainly he is a coach that anybody would want to play for. And so I think Russell Wilson would definitely have to consider his options with that. I may be biased, but I really feel like Washington would be the more attractive landing spot for Russell Wilson. Although you do look at the Las Vegas Raiders, they've got a brand new stadium. They're in the brand new location. They do have a Hall of Fame type of coach. I'm not sure if John Gruden is actually in the Hall of Fame or not, is he? But I know that he's a proven winner. He's won the Super Bowl, so, you know, certainly there's no qualms about going to the Raiders if Wilson did go to the Raiders. And certainly if Russell Wilson did go to the Raiders, then you know what that means. That means now we have Derek Carr, who was available, and probably more than likely, I think, would land in Washington. And if not Derek Carr, then you're looking at Marcus Mariota. There is a possibility that Washington could be in line to get a Marcus Mariota, a Derek Carr, or Russell Wilson. And certainly, it's going to be a no-brainer. I'm going to pick Russell Wilson every single time. You know, he's still young. He's got the Super Bowl experience, and any team that I think that he lands on is going to become an instant winner. You know, I've always been a fan of Russell Wilson, always been a fan of Alex Smith, always been a fan of Aaron Rodgers, Tom Brady, love-hate relationship. Certainly, I pulled for him in his first Super Bowl because I always thought, man, this dude, you know, he came out of nowhere and he's going to lead this team to a Super Bowl win, their first in the franchise, and then 20 years later he's still winning Super Bowls. So I think it's more for me, I think it's more of envy than anything else. Having said all that, I really think that Russell Wilson can land in Washington if Washington is willing to give up the draft capital. Now keep in mind, Washington does need some more help in that offensive line. Even though that I thought that the offensive line is pretty solid, we have always been used to having a Pro Bowl left tackle, and we had not had that in the past couple of seasons, and you can honestly see that there have been some sacks and there's been a lot of pressures and a lot of rushes. So a good solid left tackle there, that maybe a young guy that we draft this year, maybe the kid out of Virginia Tech, that could possibly be what really solidifies this team, this offense, and then certainly becomes even more an attractive landing spot for any quarterback. But if you have the option and you have the chance to get Russell Wilson, you need to go ahead and get him now. At least one thing about it, he's a very mobile quarterback, so he's going to be able to get out of trouble. He's going to be able to scramble. And honestly, he is more dangerous when he was scrambling anyway. So I really think that that could be a match made in heaven for us. So what do you think? Do you think that Washington has a shot at getting Russell Wilson? Or do you think it's just a pipe dream? Let me know in the comments section below. And the first one that leaves me a good solid comment, I will give you a shout out on my social media, which is Twitter at gsykes34. And if you really enjoyed this video, please give me a like, share it with your friends, and give me a comment. Let me know what you think. And I'm continuing to build this channel. Let me know what else you would like to see on this channel. Any topics you would like for me to cover that is Washington football related, please let me know. I'd love to do a video on it. And as always, please consider subscribing to this channel. Your support helps me so I can help you. That's all I have time for today, folks. You guys keep it simple. And guess what? Hail to the Washington football team.